Amazon's new Fire TV Stick has a new processor, a new remote, and more, and we've had time to test it out and let you know what we think. This is the Streamable's official review of the Fire TV Stick, 2020 edition. What's up, streamers? It's Tyler with the Streamable, and today we're taking a look at the all-new Fire TV Stick. It's been a while since we've seen an upgrade to the base model of the Fire TV, 2016 in fact, and now that it's here, it's still mostly what you'd expect from a base model, but with a few new bells and whistles to make your life just a little bit easier. At $39.99, the Fire TV Stick is now the middle child, in between the $29.99 Fire TV Stick Lite and the $49.99 Fire Stick 4K. The new Fire TV Stick is super affordable, and I think that's why this device is going to thrive, despite some drawbacks. It's a device for people not overly concerned with being on the bleeding edge, but who still want an upgrade from that now 4-year-old model. The next-gen Fire TV Stick has an updated 1.7 GHz processor, up from 1.3 GHz, which is a sizable boost compared to the older model. However, UI still stutters from time to time, and loading into apps and content can take just a little bit longer than you'd probably like. Hulu takes about 17 seconds to load, and loading content took anywhere from 5 to 8 seconds to load on Hulu and Disney+. The new chip is actually comparable to the one in the Fire TV Stick 4K, so any loading issues you see here will be similar to what you see on the higher end stick as well. It's still an upgrade from the 2016 model though, so you'll certainly notice a difference if that's what you're coming from. The added support for Dolby Audio and HDR are welcome additions as well. The big upgrade though is the remote. The device now comes with the same one as the Fire Stick 4K, which has three extra buttons, including a power button, a volume rocker, and a mute button, which let you control your TV and speaker system without having to swap remotes all the time. The Alexa integration works pretty well on the new remote too, taking you to specific shows, movies, or apps fairly quickly. The one thing it can't do yet is execute a request for something like, "Show me comedies on Hulu." It's either going to show you comedies or Hulu. So it's the multi-variable requests that still trip it up. The Alexa voice controls are getting an upgrade soon, however, alongside a user interface overhaul that's set to release before the end of the year. We haven't been able to use it ourselves, but from the looks of it, it seems like it'll be a pretty significant improvement. The new Alexa voice options will let you jump to a specific destination like live TV or news, and if you opt in, you can actually set it up so that the Fire TV Stick will recognize your voice and switch to your profile when you ask it to. Which, oh yeah, profiles are new too. Profiles have been a long time coming on Amazon services, and a bare bones version of profiles has already been implemented into the Prime Video apps on other devices. But on Fire TV, profiles will be like more integrated into the system. The new home screen is getting the biggest makeover in the UI update though. It looks like it's going to be much more content focused rather than app focused. The new menu bar includes tabs for Find, Live TV, and Library, and then has a set of pinned apps, which I think is a great addition. Otherwise, the home screen is full of shows and movies that you can stream with one click, streamlining the process to your content. One thing they didn't get rid of though is the huge banner of ads across the top, so that's a bummer. It actually got a bit bigger compared to the banner on the old UI. So the Fire TV Stick's got updated guts and will eventually get an updated UI, but the big thing missing from the next gen stick is 4K. The added support for Dolby Atmos sound and HDR video is there, but to get it down to the price point they were looking for, it was 4K support that they decided to leave out. Actually, it's the only difference between the Fire Stick and the Fire Stick 4K, so the only question you really have to ask yourself is, do I have a 4K TV? And unless you're really looking to save, I think the $10 extra for the Fire Stick with the new remote is definitely worth it. It's just so convenient to have even just basic TV controls on one remote. The new Fire TV Stick isn't for people looking to upgrade to the latest and greatest technologies, and I think Amazon took a very calculated look at what people want on the cheaper end of the spectrum. Bargain streamers are probably more likely to upgrade to a $600 soundbar with Dolby Atmos than a $2,500 4K TV. They'd appreciate faster load times thanks to a new processor and are less concerned with resolution. But if you're already on the 4K train, this is definitely not the streaming device for you. This or the Stick Lite could be good for a kitchen TV that's still at 1080p, especially with its small form factor, but on your 4K TV, it's not going to look good. Trust me, I tried it. So while I think this is a smart move from Amazon, I think it's only a smart buy if you're someone in that very particular market. The three versions of the Fire TV Stick are so similar now, in both price and power, that you aren't actually saving much by getting the cheaper model. But there are obviously still a lot of people in that market who haven't upgraded to 4K yet. If you are in that demographic, the Fire TV Stick might just be the streaming box for you. So what do you think? Are you going to be picking up the new and improved Fire TV Stick? Be sure to let us know down in the comments. And for more on Amazon Fire TVs and all things streaming, head over to thestreamable.com for all of our coverage. As always, I'm Tyler with The Streamable, and we'll see you in the next one.